ESPN's presentation of college football is brought to you by Honda ATVS. Get a GPS satellite navigator with the purchase of select Fortrax models.
Williams-Brice Stadium, Columbia, South Carolina. What you're looking at is a great tradition here. The Gamecocks have just taken the field to the theme of 2001. Hi, everybody. Ron Franklin, and welcome once again to Saturday primetime here on ESPN. An SEC matchup, and as you can see, the venues we get to travel week in and week out are something really special. The importance of this ball game tonight, well, you've just seen a goodly part of it. These 80,000-plus want so desperately for the Gamecocks to be a consistent, good football team, and they think that they have headed things in that direction. For Georgia, well, they had a week off after they were shocked by Southern Mississippi. The worst thing probably that could have happened to the Bulldogs simply because, Mike, they've been hammered on by the media and also by their fans. Let's talk about some of the great personnel. We'll see two super tailbacks in this ball game tonight. Robert Edwards, 5 touchdowns last year against South Carolina.
Ron, I believe the team that gets the tailback off to the best start is going to win this ball game. Robert Edwards, an excellent running back. Former coach Ray Goff moved him from a defensive back to tailback. He's only played 3 games, so he's inexperienced. On the other side of the ball, Deuce Staley. He's a former wide receiver that has moved to the tailback position. Coach Brad Scott, South Carolina's offense has changed a little bit from the Steve Tannehill passing game. They'd like to run the football with Deuce Staley. Whatever tailback gets hot tonight, got a chance to win this ballgame.
Kellen Winslow is down on the sideline. And Kellen, I guess the question to you is, if you're South Carolina, how do you stop Robert Edwards?
Well, Mike and Ron, I was talking to Coach Scott for South Carolina about Robert Edwards. He said, well, I saw the film last week. He only gained 61 yards, but he was an inch away from breaking it every time. 8 men up on the line of scrimmage. They're going to go after him.
All right, Kellen. 5 touchdowns last year, and it is an absolutely wonderful night for college football. Temperature tonight, in fact, going to be as mild as it has been in the South Carolina area for a long time. In fact, they're saying temperature down into the 50s this evening before this ball game is over. First year at the University of Georgia, Jim Donnan, and he said last night, I'd given anything in the world if we had been able to play last Saturday to try to cure some of our ills in that ball game that they had against Southern Mississippi. Georgia won the toss. They deferred. So we are taking a look at the Gamecocks on offense first this evening. Cousin and Staley, Deuce number 22, back in the dual safety, and this one's underway. It's going to come down at the goal line, and Staley. Little running room across the 20 and out to the 25-yard line. Let's take a look at the starters for South Carolina. Anthony Wright, boy, you got to defend him because besides Staley, he could really get out and take off. Steve Mixon is the fullback. The wide receivers, Zola Davis, probably the new go-to guy, but Corey Bridges is a sprint man on the track team. Jason Lawson, the tight end, he's used primarily as a blocker. And up front, Nesbitt has been moved from right guard. He is possible all-conference. Whitfield, Beckwith, Rubiak, and Stinchcomb or check it Wheeler on that offensive front. Staley. 7, 8, 9, almost 10 yards on the play. And let's take a look at the starters defensively for the Georgia Bulldogs tonight. Particularly these two defensive tackles, Ferguson and Jermaine Smith. Very active and very good. The linebackers, well, solid group. Tolbert, Bright, and Brian Jones. And in the secondary, Corey Johnson is the old veteran. Ford Sipe and Ronald Bailey rounding out the group in the secondary. 11 yards on that first play by Staley. Deuce will get it again. This time to the left side. He will take it for 4 as Brian Jones comes from that weak side linebacker position.
Ron, the South Carolina has changed their philosophy. Last year, you remember Steve Tannehill throwing the ball 30, 40 times a game. This year, Brad Scott wants to turn the ball game into a shorter game, wants to run the football, put it in the hands of Deuce Staley and see what they can get accomplished with the running game.
Anthony Wright. Wright, very capable. You got to stay at home for the nakeds and the bootlegs. But this man right here, as Mike said, is the fellow they're hanging their hat on. And he's going to take it for another first down as they spot it at the 46-yard line. And Greg Bright from his linebacking position is there to halt him.
Well, where Georgia has to make a lot of big plays is a defensive line. They'll play 10 defensive linemen here to start the ball game. They'll just alternate them in the first quarter and the second quarter, trying to stay, have fresh people with that stop the run and rush the passer. But as this game goes along, as the success they're having running the football, that's going to open up Anthony Wright, the young sophomore quarterback for South Carolina.
Wright, 6'2", 192, a redshirt sophomore out of Vanceboro, North Carolina. And it looks as though Travis Whitfield came out of his stance a little quickly.
Dead ball, false start, offense, be a third down.
Mac Gentry, the referee tonight. He is out of Knoxville, Tennessee. And, of course, Southeastern Conference game, all SEC officials. Third down. They need the 46-yard line to pick up this first down. And you see South Carolina with the three wide outs and one setback. First pass of the night. Got it on the money. It is complete to Bridges, and Glenn Ford will usher him out of bounds, but that is a South Carolina first down.
Nice throw by Anthony Wright to Corey Bridges, but good pass protection. You're going to watch Georgia's defensive line. They cannot get to Anthony Wright. Good pass protection. Glenn Ford on the coverage, but Corey Bridges with a good cushion over there for the completion.
So South Carolina comes out, starts the drive at the 25-yard line. They have picked up a couple of first downs now and almost at midfield. Staley again. Big opening this time, and that offensive line, Mike, Whitfield and also Beckwith with a nice job in the middle, and they're going to have about 5 yards in the play.
Here is what I was talking about earlier. Right here, the two defensive tackles, Jermaine Smith and Jason Ferguson, they're a load right in there, and they've got to be able to block them, and they do a nice job blocking them. Greg Bright overran the play a little bit, and Deuce Staley with a cutback. Paul Snelling made the tackle.
Beckwith, the junior out of Palatka, Florida, number 53, comes out over the football. Staley again. They send the linebacker, going to be hit in the backfield, and it's Brian Jones who will drop him for a loss, and all of a sudden South Carolina is going to be looking at a third down and long situation, and immediately Georgia comes in with the two extra defensive backs.
Brian Jones, the outside linebacker, is just going to scrape off. He's at the top of your screen. There's no one to block him. Deuce Staley had to be a bust in the blocking scheme there, Ron, because Deuce Staley never got a chance. You see the linebacker just take the open gap. Brian Jones shoot the gap and make the tackle.
Yep, he did. He came unabated. So Jones now with a couple of early stops on this drive. And as we said, third down, and they need the 42 of Georgia. Here comes the blitz from the corner, and the linebacker gets his pass away. And we have a flag. Corey Johnson with the cover, and they say no. Good defense. And, of course, the South Carolina crowd does not agree.
But Corey Johnson's an excellent defensive back, was able to make that deflection. But the pressure on Anthony Wright is really what caused the incompletion. Brad Scott not happy with that. Felt like his left hand of Corey Johnson was in the receiver's back.
Mike, this is the freshman, Courtney Levitt, who was out of Germantown, Tennessee. Has a very good leg and good hang time. Maybe still a tad slow in getting his kicks off. Good hanging spiral here. Hines Ward signals his teammates to get away from it, and it's going to go dead just inside the 20. So it's a 30-yard kick, and there's a timeout. We'll take it with him. Just over 11 to play, first quarter. When we come back, Georgia on offense. Our good friends at Kroger Store flies very high tonight at Williams-Brice Stadium in their blimp, the Spirit of Atlanta, to help ESPN bring you this exciting SEC contest tonight. Boy, they've got a great evening up there. Not a cloud that we can see for miles. And very mild. You can see Hamburg. trick, number 18, the linebacker, faking the blitz. And here comes Edwards. First carry of the night, and they are all around him. Able to have a couple of yards, but that's it. Let's take a look at those starters on offense. Mike Bobo, he's back after that broken leg. Edwards, as we said, a great game last year. Selma Callaway is the fullback. The wide receivers, this is a very good and veteran group. Hines Ward, Juan Daniels, and look for Larry Brown tonight. They may throw to the tight end some. And up front, Meadows, Beatles, Stafford, Antonio Fleming, and Matt Stinchcomb making up that offensive front. For Adam Meadows, he is making his 28th consecutive start on that offensive line for Georgia. Gain of a yard and a half, Bobo on the draw play. Edwards again, breaks one tackle, cannot get by the second, and is going to be stopped just short of the 25-yard line. And let's take a look at the starters on defense for South Carolina. Caldwell, Taylor, Maddox, and Sylvester Miller. The linebackers, they really have been helped by number 18, Darren Hambrick, out of Lacoochee, Florida. Young and Burnham, the other two linebackers. And in the secondary, cousin Ben Washington is the veteran back there. Arturo Freeman has the reputation of being a real hitter. And Karis Sullivan is the other cornerback. Third down. They need five. Here's a look at Hambrick right there. First pass, he got it for the first down out of the 35-yard line. Corey Allen making the reception, so Georgia moves the chains after a third down and five situation.
And that's important to get Mike Bobo off with a good start, Ron. Jim Donnan, when you take over a new job and a coaching job, the transition period's difficult on the players. All of a sudden, somebody else recruited them, and now a new guy standing in front of them. So this is the first road game. They're a little tight. A good confidence builder for Mike Bobo.
You see, Georgia lines up in a two tight end alignment, one setback, and the two wide receivers. I guess trying to get South Carolina to balance up that defense a little bit. Edwards gets by one tackler, then will take it for a couple of yards. Brody on the stop.
Well, you're exactly right. When you play a defense and you bring in two tight ends, you're trying to get a helmet on a helmet. You want to bring an extra blocker in to get a helmet on a helmet. And, Ron, I think the important thing tonight, we set it up in our open, it's Deuce Staley against Robert Edwards and both teams, because the running game is going to be such a factor of which tailback can get his team in that end zone.
Both coaches made a solid point yesterday of saying to us they want to be able to run the football. We're going to see a lot of running plays in this game tonight. Draw play. Spinning off one tackler is Kurtzy. Breaks it big across midfield and down to the 43-yard line before Ben Washington stopped him. And Torin Kurtzy has answered the question, yes, he is 100%. That's a 20-yard gain.
And Georgia is going to play two backs in the backfield at the same time tonight, figuring that South Carolina is going to key on Robert Edwards, and all of a sudden Torin Kurtzy, number 20, hits him with a draw. And Ron also looked for him to throw the ball out of that set because they get two good running backs on the linebackers. Kurtzy looks very good there. Good speed.
Well, while you're looking for number 47, here comes number 20 at you for 20 yards. Pressure is on, pass is thrown high and incomplete, as Lee Wiggins was out there to make the defensive play, but Bobo a little bit tall on that one.
And Ron, we had the Tennessee game last year, and Mike Bobo and Robert Edwards really had a coming out party, and you can see last year with Mike Bobo, before he was hurt in the Ole Miss game, they averaged 36 points a game. Without him, you can see the drop-off, but Southern Miss blitzed him a lot. He may not have the mobility he had before he got his leg hurt, but tonight's a big night for him too, because really this is only his second ball game coming back from that injury.
Yep. Fumbles the snap. South Carolina has recovered at the 46, and it's Sylvester Miller, number 55, will get off that football.
And in talking to Jim Donnan, he said in the Southern Miss game they went the wrong way about four times. The backs, they had a lot of missed plays. And here again, the center quarterback exchange, which is so valuable and so important, they give good field position to South Carolina.
Yeah, last week, in fact, there was a play where in the end zone where Bobo and the running back collided. The ball was turned loose, and it's... Anyway, those are the kind of things that happen to you when you're snake bit and you're not as focused as you should be.
Well, they're nervous. They're a little nervous yet. New staff again, they're still nervous over this.
Deuce Staley. Deuce is going to have five, maybe six. Greg Wright and Brian Jones combining on that tackle.
And, Ron, what I mean by that is, you know, you go through a whole recruiting process with your ball club, Ray Goff and staff recruiting, and then all of a sudden, one day you wake up and here's a new guy standing in front of you, and you don't know what to expect from him. He doesn't know what to expect from you. This is the first road game together. There's a lot of things that go into that coaching transition.
So the offense talks it over on the sideline, and they had an outstanding drive going, highlighted by that 20-yard run by Kirksey. But now South Carolina with the ball right back. Counterplay, and on the tray, here's Deuce Staley. It's a nice job defensively by Ron Bailey. Also, Chris Terry over to make the tackle. I love what Joe Kine said about Terry last night when we were talking. He said the only way to explain it is he's finally growing into his body. He's 6'7". He's now at 260. But he said that he was just gawky at a time and typical of a youngster who has grown very rapidly.
And you see Joe Kine's on your screen here. He was the defensive coordinator under Ray Goff. They kept him here, and their defenses got out quick against Southern Miss and tonight against South Carolina. A little bit more stability there because they know what to expect second year.
If you just joined us, just over seven to play, opening quarter, and no score. That pass is caught by Zola Davis and out of bounds with the first down plus about 8 yards, and Trey Sipe defensively bumps him out of bounds.
We talked about the run setting up the pass, and that's exactly what's happened to South Carolina. Because they've been effective running Deuce Staley, all of a sudden Georgia creeping in with that eighth guy, which gets man coverage on the outside. Zola Davis wide open against the strong safety.
Trevon Matthews, number 86, comes into the lineup as you look at Deuce Staley. The wide receivers were even kidding Deuce after last week, saying, hey, if you get it 30 times, that means we only get it a couple of times. And the coach said, yeah, it may stay that way. Wright reverses it, throws it complete, and Bridges on the receiving end, and that is another South Carolina first down. Mike, talk about the pressure that Wright puts on a defense.
Well, here's what's going to happen. You're going to watch this defensive end come inside. He is supposed to check the quarterback right here. He doesn't do it. But because the running game's successful, all of a sudden Anthony Wright is outside of you. Now he can run or he can pass. Corey Bridges is open for the first down.
And
he's got so much speed, Ron, that if he gets on that corner, bad things are going to happen to your defense.
Last thing Joe Kine said last night, I have screamed and shouted at my kids, you got to stay at home for the reverses and the boots on this kid, because he can burn you.
He just had the living proof.
13 yards on that play. Deepest penetration for either club tonight. Going to go for the end zone. Got Bridges open. Touchdown, South Carolina. So we'll take a break. They are on their feet here at Williams-Brice. They're on top, 7-0. So it's 7-0, South Carolina, and the home folks, over 80,000 strong, in total agreement, they like the start in this football game. 6:32 to play in this opening quarter. And for Wright, he was 3 of 3 hitting that man, Bridges, for the touchdown. Ward and Patrick Pass and a twin safety for the Georgia Bulldogs. And of course Pass, the heralded freshman. And this is a line drive kick. Going to be tough to field. In fact, it'll go out of bounds. Hines Ward said, I'll let this one go.
Kick out of bounds. Put the ball in play at the 35-yard line.
McGentry says put it in play at the 35. And there's a break of the action. 7-0 South Carolina. We'll be right back. South Carolina 7-0, 6:32 to play, opening quarter. Corey Bridges, three catches already for 42 yards and a touchdown. As you look over that offensive front for the Georgia Bulldogs, Meadows, Beadle, Stafford, Fleming, and Stinchcomb. That is big number 79 there, 6'7", 280 out of Lilburn, Georgia. Running play, Edwards, penetration, but he gets by them. He'll have 2, maybe 3 yards. And let's go back and look at the drive, Mike.
Well, the key play, of course, is Mike Bobo on the quarterback exchange. I can't really tell whether the ball ever got up to Mike Bobo. It's a fumble between he and the center. South Carolina came right back against the blitz, took advantage of it with Anthony Wright throwing the corner route. Look at this route by Corey Bridges. Inside fake, wide open on the outside against man coverage for the touchdown. South Carolina with the lead.
Remember I said in the introductions, he is a track man, and he's the 100-yard sprinter. And boy, he showed it on that one. Now we've had a flag that has been thrown, and a major penalty stepped off against South Carolina. And it will go across midfield to the 45-yard line. It was a major for a face mask violation. Shotgun, they throw back the screen back into the boundary. That's Hines Ward. 40, 35, and he is up. There is a flag down at the line of scrimmage. It would appear to be a 45-yard touchdown, and let's see if it's going to stand or not.
Well, I think it's going to be a holding call against Georgia.
Mike, they're going to bring it back.
Holding, offense, 10 yards, and it's called a foul. Replay the down, first down.
You know, Jim Donovan's got to be thinking, what do I have to do or what have I done wrong? Because everything they have touched has not been turning gold.
Well, I was going to say, this is a big drive for Georgia because they need something good to happen, but it's too early in the ball game to crack. This Georgia football team had some problems against Southern Mississippi, a new staff. I keep harping on that, but they need to settle down a little bit because they're moving the football on offense. Keep the ball in Robert Edwards' hand. Good things will happen for Georgia.
Again from the shotgun formation. Bobo puts it in the stomach of Edwards. At the 50, 45, still on his feet, almost broke another tackle, and he's down at the 36-yard line, and let's check in for the first time tonight with Mike Tirico. Mike, what do you have for us, buddy?
Well, Ron, let's check out that game over on the Deuce. When we left you before the game, it was Vanderbilt on the fake punt leading 15-9. Freddie Kitchens leads Bama back down the field. 6 yards to Marcel West, tied the game. Extra point block, snapping 135 good in a row. So it's a tie game, early third.
Ron, that Vanderbilt team is not a fluke.
Yeah.
I mean, offensively, they're going to grow. Defensively, they'll play with anybody.
Mike, that was a gain of 19 yards by Edwards, so it's second down and short. Bobo possibly with an audible as South Carolina is really jumping around on defense, trying to confuse him. Edwards, look at that hole. Has 5, has 10, ran into his own man, lost the football, and South Carolina has recovered at the 23. Is that unbelievable or what?
Well, it's unbelievable, but what Jim Donnan has to do, and he's been around coaching for a long time. He coached in Missouri, Oklahoma, and Marshall. He's got to settle his football team down because they can't think this is a snowball going down the hill and just getting bigger and bigger because their good things are happening. You're going to see a cutback by Robert Edwards. Everybody overruns this play. Now, Robert Edwards is going to run into his own blocker right here, and that's what caused the fumble. That shouldn't cause the fumble if the running back's got the ball in hand strong enough. And Juan Daniels, the collision and the recovery by South Carolina's Lee Wiggins.
So Juan Daniels, his teammate, actually caused the fumble when he ran into it. Stadler, a deuce, fights his way out to in the vicinity of the 30-yard line. Now, Deuce is not a real big guy. He has lost about 15 pounds, but he seems very durable. And I asked him yesterday, I said, are you capable of carrying the ball 30, 35 times in a game? And he said, absolutely. Absolutely.
There's no doubt, Ron. He carried it 29 times against Central Florida, and he'll carry it 25-plus tonight.
7-0 if you've just joined us. South Carolina leading. We're about to go under 4 minutes to play in this opening quarter. Staley again. This time hit at the line of scrimmage, and it's Jermaine Smith, the big senior from Augusta, Georgia. Well, next Thursday, tune in at 7:30 p.m. for the weekend kickoff show. Catch all the insights and predictions. Then at 8 o'clock, it is an ACC battle as Warrick Dunn and the number 3 Seminoles head to North Carolina State. Next week here on ESPN. Ron Franklin, Mike Gottfried, and Kellen Winslow coming to you from a very excited Williams-Brice Stadium in Columbia, South Carolina. Right after fumbling the snap, Greg Bright is there to just devour him. Also, Jermaine Smith was coming up very quickly. Both quarterbacks, a little bit of nerves right now.
Well, Greg Bright is the senior leader of this football, junior leader of this defense. He had 17 tackles last week, but he's what makes this team go on defense. But good penetration, they have a little crossing stunt up inside. Joe Kine's trying to turn up the heat. Greg Bright, bad snap for Anthony Wright, but a big play for Georgia.
See if they come after Levin. Nope. Off the side of his foot. This is not real long, and the up back made the catch. And a flag's going to come down because he did not give him the 2 yards protection. And the person he didn't give the protection is Corey Johnson. And let's check in again with Mike Tirico. Mike.
All right, Ron. Southern Cal in this McDonald's breakaway out in the Coliseum. They lead Oregon State just 6-3. But Brad Otten, 16 yards to Rodney Sermons. Oregon State's run just 6 plays in the second quarter. And the Trojans lead by 10 right before halftime.
All righty, Mike. Thanks so much. Our situation, just under 3 minutes to play in his opening quarter. And Mac Gentry making the announcement now, as we suspected, that 5 yards would be stepped off because South Carolina didn't give him the safety gap of 2 yards.
Ron, even though South Carolina's ahead 7-0, I like the way Georgia's playing. I like their play. I like their plan of attack on offense. If they keep making mistakes, they're going to move the football down here and score.
Robert Edwards again. 10, 15, 20. He is inside the 10-yard line. Terry Cousin saved a touchdown, and Edwards proving why he had 5 touchdowns last year.
Yeah, you just get the feel. I get the feel standing up here that Georgia owns the offensive line. And when you have a running back like Robert Edwards, see the cut he made? He was going to work up inside, and he skated to the outside. Now he's in the secondary. And he has to carry this offense.
Those fullbacks never get credit, and let's give it to Selma Callaway. Excellent block on that play. Edwards, nothing this time. Nice job defensively. Arturo Freeman, the sophomore out of Orangeburg, South Carolina, wraps him up.
Ron, this is the important graphic tonight. 2 great tailbacks playing in this ballgame. We're going to chart them. The minutes are on the field, how many times they touch the ball, yards, and scores. Robert Edwards and Deuce Staley. Here's the start of it right now. 8 touches for Edwards, 67 yards, 10 for Staley, 62 yards.
You can see how valuable they both are to their respective teams.
When the night's over, one of those guys is going to have a distinct advantage.
Allen in the ballgame at wide receiver. Bobo, this is a very loud crowd. I don't know if they can check these audible or not. But a flag comes down. I think he got caught too much time.
Dead ball, false start, offense.
Well, that's a 5-yard penalty for the crowd, Mike. And going back into that end zone, it's very difficult. Join John Miller and Joe Morgan for the ESPN Sunday Night Baseball Game of the Week. Tomorrow, they will be in the friendly confines of Wrigley Field for the Philadelphia Phillies against the Cubs. That's tomorrow, 8 o'clock Eastern Time here on ESPN.
Ron, I like Mike Bobo. I think he's just inexperienced, but he showed us at Tennessee last year what he can do as a quarterback. He's very accurate.
He was very poised that night. Here he comes on the option. Pitches it back to Edwards, and Edwards, still on his feet, going to step out of bounds just inside the 5, and it's Freeman along with Hambrick, combining in the stops.
See, what Mike Bobo brings to the table is not just a good passing quarterback, but here he made a good decision on the option. He's looking for the pitch. He knows he gets the pitch. Darren Hambrick's going to make the tackle. But now you got Robert Edwards out in the corner, turned upfield with that strong body of his, 6'2", 208. Good move by Mike Bobo.
Third down. Goal. The ball 2.5 yards away from the end zone. Edwards fumbles the pitch, falls on it back at the 7-yard line.
There's too many mistakes. But again, Jim Donnan's coaching tonight is to settle this football team down. He's on the road first time with this team. Just settling his team down because they had success here in the first quarter. It's 1:03 in the quarter. They've moved the ball down the field. They've stopped themselves. South Carolina has not stopped Georgia.
That's twice that Edwards has fumbled. He lost one. He got this one, but it cost him dearly. And now Langley will attempt the field goal of 24 yards. He missed it. From that close, he missed it.
Well, everything that can go wrong is going wrong for Georgia. And you got to credit South Carolina. They put pressure on the kick. Darren Hamrick.
Let's check in with Kellen Winslow down on the sideline. Kellen?
Well, Ron and Mike, South Carolina right now is playing inspiring football, but they're giving up a lot of yardage. Last year, this team defensively was last in the SEC in points allowed and yards per game. As of right now, they've dodged 3, maybe 4 bullets.
Well, Edwards right now had 90 yards, Kellen, until that last play, and he lost 5, so he's at 85 on 10 carries. That's pretty good clip per tote at 8.5. Deuce Staley will take it for a gain of close to 5, and Tootle comes up to make the hit. They're checking over Edwards on the sideline. And Mike, I think he's a little shaken up, besides the fact that they're probably talking confidence with him as well. 15 seconds down to 14, and that could have been the final play of this opening quarter. As Anthony Wright comes to the line of scrimmage, I'm not sure if, he's looking up at the clock now. Just going to let it run down, and that is the end of the opening quarter. So as we change into the field, South Carolina 7 and Georgia nothing. On the sideline, the Georgia offense huddles. And, sometimes, Mike, you can just start to try too hard. And they've proven they're very good. I mean, Edwards almost had 100 yards in the first quarter.
Yeah, Jim Donnan, as you see him walk silent, his biggest concern's got to be the defense, though, because South Carolina has moved the ball against his defense.
Second down and 5, if you've just tuned in. Fake the draw. He gets hammered. Jermaine Smith is the man who came through and hitting just as he was delivering the pass.
Well, that's the reason you substitute a lot of defensive linemen, Joe Kynes, because what you want early in the year is to play a lot of people at the defensive tackle and defensive end so you build some depth, and then late in the fourth quarter when you got to chase a quarterback down, you got a fresh big man to run him down.
You know, Wright's going to have to be careful. I know he's 6'2", 192, but last week, 4 different times, he holds the ball so long, Mike. He's a very gutsy guy. He got hit just as he was throwing. That can take its toll after a time. Gets this one away, and that is a nice play by Zola Davis just to keep it from being intercepted. He knocked it down, really.
That's what Georgia needed, a defensive stand to get their offense back on the field again. So a good series by Georgia defensively. Anthony Wright, just no protection on the second down play, which causes him to punt the football.
Hines Ward is back in the deep safety spot, and 27 Corey Johnson is short as Levitt will kick it away. And they've got the return on this one, and off the side of his foot again. Hits just across the 50. And takes a little bit more roll, but that one's not going to net very much. A 29-yard punt by the freshman, Courtney Levitt. Mike, let's talk about key plays in that opening quarter.
Well, Georgia made every mistake you could make in the first quarter. They've had 3 fumbles. Mike Bobo starts it off with the exchange for the center, and Mike Bobo, that's the first fumble. Second one, Robert Edwards runs into Juan Daniels and drops the ball as Georgia was moving in for a score. And then here's the pitch where I don't believe Robert Edwards ever had the ball, dropped it, and along with a holding call that brought back a touchdown and a missed field goal, it's been a mistake.
Bobo hit from behind, and is going to be knocked down for a huge loss by Marsters. And that's one of the young freshmen that South Carolina is so excited about.
Well, he really just came from the snap, and then South Carolina had a nice defense called for what Georgia was trying to do on offense, a delayed double screen that just took too long. And Matt Marsters just made the sack and gives Georgia bad field position.
By the way, Mike, we talk about the miscues in the first quarter. Don't forget the holding penalty that killed a 44-yard touchdown. South Carolina calls a timeout. I think they only got 10 men on the field, so we'll get it changed and set properly. We'll be right back. Here over Williams-Brice Stadium, and that's the eye on the sky tonight. It's the Kroger Food Store's blimp, the spirit of Atlanta. We are very glad to have them with us here tonight.
Ron, when you get put in this kind of situation, second and 25, what you want to do is just get a play, short little pass, get yourself 10 or 12 back to get you back to where you're third and 10 again.
Under pressure, he is sacked again as 95, the other freshman there so high on, John Abraham, records a sack. So the two first-year players right out of high school pay dividends immediately.
Well, I know when I talked to the South Carolina coaches, especially Wally Burnham, the defensive coordinator, he didn't feel like Mike Bobo showed a lot of mobility in the first ball game. But again, you could show all the mobility you want. There's just nothing there, and there's no blocking right there. John Abraham makes the tackle.
Mike, the amazing thing about him, he only played 1 year of high school football from a very small school in South Carolina. Draw play to Edwards. Gets by one. Gets by a second. And Edwards going to be close to picking up the first down. In fact, he's going to be about 4 yards shy as Corey Allen, one of the wide receivers, threw a key block in the play. And let's see where they're going to spot him down. Well, they say he stepped out of bounds. I'm sorry, they're not going to give him quite what we thought they were. 27 on the play. They say he stepped out around the 47.
Nice safe call. Draw a play to put it into Robert Edwards' hands, and now he gives you a punter a chance to kick South Carolina in the hole. Boy, he's impressive, Robert Edwards. He was impressive in that Tennessee game last year.
Listen, he's over 100 yards now, and we've got 13-10 to play until halftime.
South Carolina, I believe, only has 10 people on the field right now. One short.
Langley's kick. Staley calls for the fair catch. That hit a Georgia player. So, an illegal touch. And it happened at the 23-yard line. 29 yards in the punt.
What they're discussing, Ron, is whether or not he had a chance to catch that ball, or whether Georgia just got in his way and kept him from catching the football. Drew Staley trying to work up to catch the football. Hit a Georgia player on the helmet.
As Terry. And so South Carolina will scrimmage from the 22-and-a-half-yard line. We'll take a break. Back with more right after this. And now for tonight's Burger King Students of the Game from Georgia, strong safety Trey Syke. He's an agriculture engineering major with an average of 3.2 in the classroom. And from South Carolina, kicker Reed Morton. He is majoring in interdisciplinary studies and has a 3.8 GPA. Burger King congratulates these fine student athletes. Some of what is going to be a record crowd in the background there as you get a good look from almost field level. 7-0. South Carolina leads. Staley bounces off one tackle, gets back to the outside, and is across the 35 for the first down. That's going to be a gain of about 13 yards, and let's check in again with Mike Tirico. Mike.
Brown, the lead has changed hands in Tuscaloosa and on the deuce. 4th and 2, Gene Stallings says let's option and go for it. And look who kept it, Freddie Kitchens. 50 footwork, 14-yard option. They make the extra point. Bama leads Vandy by 4.
Pretty Kitchens makes it happen somehow.
Reminds you a little bit about Jay Barker a few years ago. He always had those comeback wins for Alabama. Yeah.
Wright sits comfortably in the pocket, going long, and he's got a man down there, and incomplete as the collision occurs out of bounds. It was Marcus Robinson that he was looking for. I talked about Bridges, Mike, and his sprinting ability. Well, Marcus Robinson also is a track man and has great speed.
Ron, watch this play right here. Deuce Staley is going to sneak out into the flat, and watch how open he is. Now, coaches upstairs will watch this play, and of course, Anthony Wright's going to throw it. Hold it right here. If we could stop it right here. Look at Staley is wide open over there in the flat, so the coach upstairs will see that, and then you'll see that play again real soon.
John Reeves probably is the man who will be hollering to the sideline saying, hey, let's take a look-see again because they blew a coverage. Quick pass here. Nicely executed right on the sideline. Zona Davis and Brandon Tolbert is there to push him out of bounds. You have to like Anthony Wright and the poise that he shows for only his second start and his first start in an SEC game.
Well, South Carolina coaches him very, very well because they sit down with him before each game and say, okay, now you list your plays, your top 10 plays that you like to throw, and they want him to feel comfortable with what he's doing, and they call the plays that he likes because he's a young quarterback.
You know, he and Charlie Ward are distantly related, and they have become very good friends. And in fact, he said Charlie talked with him this week. And as much as anything, it's a calming effect, and he just talks to him about situational things, about how you handle the pressure, how you gain poise, and what you do for a big ball game.
Well, Charlie is going to call Anthony Wright every Friday night along with Ward Dunn. You see, this is his locker right here. Anthony Wright and Charlie Ward is in his, they put a picture of Charlie Ward in his locker, and he idolizes him. And Charlie picks up the phone. He says, I got to call my gang, Ward Dunn and Anthony Wright.
He also mentioned yesterday in our visit with him that John Reeves has been so helpful to him as far as helping him understand what the coverages are and so that he's not deceived when defense coordinators are trying to use a little trickery. Wright could be changing this first down play. Plenty of time on the 25-second clock. Deuce Staley on the carry. Nice cutback, and he's going to be hit by Greg Bright. And let's check in again with Mr. Tirico. Mike.
Mr. Franklin, we told everyone on game day, score a defensive touchdown thus far this year, you win 70% of your games. Guess what's coming here? Interception by the strong safety, Kevin Jackson. He's gone. Two touchdowns within 21 seconds. Now Bama's lead on the Deuce is 11.
Boy, that's a killer situation. Vanderbilt is in the ballgame. They go down in Tuscaloosa, but then they come back and give up that one, and that's a backbreaker.
They have just a young offense. They're not quite ready yet on offense.
Staley, what a cutback. Still on his feet, and he breaks it again. Deuce Staley is going to score from 51 yards. Saturday nights. That may be as pretty a run as we have had as far as sheer athletic ability.
There's no doubt he uses the cutback lane. Everything's zone blocked by the offensive lineman. What I mean by that is they come off the ball together and they block whatever's in their way. They just make a lateral step to the right, block it, and Deuce Staley has to find the hole. But not only did he find the hole, he was able to cut back a couple different times to take it the distance for the touchdown.
Courtney Levitt attempting the extra point. It's blocked. Georgia scrambles for the ball. It is lateral back and going to be recovered by South Carolina. So the play, still loose. Mike, let's go back and look at this run. I don't know how many cutbacks Deuce Staley has, but look how many people he makes miss.
Watch his ability to cut. There's the first cut. Now he gets into the secondary. Now he sets up the safety. That's the second cut. Working up the football field. Always has his head on a swivel, his eyes, vision, trying to find the next player, Georgia player, he has to break away from. Then showing you his strength and running away from the Georgia defensive secondary.
That's one of those things where Joe Kiens will sit in the meeting next week and count out six different guys that probably should have made the tackle, and he just made a miss. Right now, he has 13 carries for 108 yards as we look at the comparison.
When you look at that chart, they've both been on the field about the same amount of times, 131 yards for Staley, but the biggest thing is Robert Edwards has dropped the ball twice. Other than that, they're even except for the score by Deuce Staley, but you can't make the mistakes of dropping the football. Very impressive running back, Deuce Staley.
Make sure that you understand what you saw. He did have a kick return. That's the reason it showed 14 touches, but his runs from scrimmage are 108 yards for 13.
And they will throw him the football.
Yep, a little bit of everything. Hines Ward is backbeat. Speaking of a guy who can do everything, Ward has played receiver, running back, and quarterback. And it's going to be pass on the return as a flag comes from deep downfield, and he is stopped at the 22.
Troy Hamrick on the stop for Carolina. Good day, Mark.
Block in the back on the return, 10 yards from the end of the run, first down.
So Georgia will be penalized, and let's check again with Kellen Winslow. Kellen.
Ron and Mike, we saw the great run by Deuce Staley, just an excellent, he has great vision and the ability to cut back. As Mike said, he kept his head on the swivel as he was coming downfield. But his road here, he's from West Columbia, not too far away from the stadium, but he much traveled to get here as he signed with the University of Hawaii out of high school. Then he went back to JUCO in Mississippi and then came back home to Columbia. They're glad to have him and he's glad to be here.
Well, he played at Itawamba Junior College, and he played with Jason Ferguson, the outstanding defensive tackle for the Georgia Bulldogs. Bobo to Edwards, and he gets loose. Well, you're going to say tit for tat. It sure looks like it all night long as these two tailbacks are just putting on a display.
Georgia's entering a dangerous area where you can't dig that well too deep and expect to get out on the road. Now, this is a hostile crowd here, South Carolina. They're behind their ball club. They have to have something good happen on these next couple drives and get some points on the board. Otherwise, they're going to dig this hole too deep.
Yep, that's a good point. And for the home folks, particularly when you're playing as an underdog, which South Carolina is tonight, the longer they hang around, and they're more than hanging around, the more confidence they get. Hines Ward out of reverse, and he's going to be hit by Darren Hambrick, and close to the first down. They'll catch NFL countdown tomorrow. Boomer and the boys start your NFL day off right. Watch as Don Shula looks at life after football, and the question is, how does he spend his Sundays now? And why, after 4 years in the league, is the Patriots' Drew Bledsoe having so many difficulties? NFL countdown tomorrow, 11:30. 10:51 left until halftime. Carolina 13 and Georgia nothing. Short yardage. Bobo will take it straight ahead and they'll get the first down.
Jim Donnan, after the first ball game against Southern Mississippi, he said he needed to get Robert Edwards a rest every now and then, and he's bringing in Torrin Kirksey. Kirksey's already carried the ball one time, showed you his speed also.
Yep, he had a 20-yard gain. Kirksey's an interesting story. He had committed to Brad Scott that he was coming here and wound up at the University of Georgia. Led this Georgia team in rushing last year with 603 yards. As Bobo sets in the pocket, and he just rushed it. Larry Brown, the tight end, and his intended receiver.
Mike Bobo played 2 years behind Eric Zier. You look at Robert Edwards. I think he's just getting a break right here now, Ron. Just trying to get rested a little bit. He's ran the ball quite a bit here in the first half. 12 times. Trying to spell him a little bit with Torrin Kirksey. Let's see if they try to put the ball in Kirksey's hand here, either with a draw or throwing a little pass to him out of the backfield.
Second down and 10. Bobo, nice protection right over the middle. Hines Ward, 35, and knocked out of bounds after he picks up the first down at the 37. Ray Green is there. It's going to be a gain of 12.
Hines Ward.
We talked about Hines Ward. He played quarterback in high school. He's played quarterback, running back, wide receiver. He's done everything here. Kick returner. But I think the interesting thing is when the coaches talked to him and they said, we want to move you to wide receiver, he says, I'll go anywhere to help this football team. But he's a dangerous player that South Carolina has to look and see where he lines up all the time with reverses and screen passes. They always want to know where Hines Ward's at.
Well, for instance, he had 103 yards in receptions against Carolina last year. But at quarterback against Virginia in the Peach Bowl, he threw for over 400 yards. Kirksey going to be knocked down at the 39. And speaking of versatile, the most famous double threat in Georgia history, well, that has to be Frank Sinkwich. He ran and threw his way, in fact, to a Heisman Trophy. That was 1942. But Georgia may also have the only triple threat in college football history in Hines Ward. Not only has he started at quarterback and running back and wide receiver, he's recorded 100-plus yards in games at each of those positions. That is truly outstanding. That's a guy you talk about. Most people, they say jack of all trades and a
master of none.
Master of none, but he's been a master of all.
That's right. Robert Edwards back in the ballgame for Georgia. They're going to take a timeout.
So we'll take the timeout with them. South Carolina 13, Georgia nothing.
On the Milo scoreboard.
Let's go. Yeah, go ahead.
We're back 13 to nothing, South Carolina. Second quarter, and you see we've just gone under 10 minutes to play until halftime. And number 47, Robert Edwards, back in the ballgame after getting a breather for a couple of plays.
He's got a blitz coming here. He's got to be able to get out of this.
Marsters and Abraham, the two freshman defensive ends, are in the ballgame, and the hot route is there as Hines Ward makes the reception, and Ray Green meets him immediately, but Mike is right. I think he checked off there, and they did a good job of picking up the blitz, 13 yards.
He feels good about himself right now, Mike Bobo, because you're going to see this player right here jump and blitz from the outside, and they show it too soon. South Carolina makes a mistake here and gives it too much time. Then Hines Ward gets across the face of the defensive back, Karen Sullivan, and made the catch. You can't allow him across your face like that.
So they are across midfield again. He had a 44-yard touchdown call back because of holding. Now he can throw. This is a lateral. And Ward on the pass has got it knocked away. Corey Allen covered closely by Arturo Freeman.
What a great play by Arturo Freeman, the safety. That's why you have the center fielder in the middle of the field, the free safety, because of the range. Arturo Freeman is going to be standing here now. He sees the motion man now. Hines Ward is going to go to the outside behind the quarterback, which means a double pass is available. Now Freeman knows that he can't get up. There's no need for him to get up right away, so he plays Corey Allen. Perfect, knocks the ball away. Hines Ward gets hit after the play by Maynard Caldwell.
Short drop, pressure is on, it falls tipped at the line of scrimmage. It is alive, and it's intercepted by Washington. He's got a blocker in front. Washington tackled by Edwards at the 11-yard line. Maddox got a hand on it.
Ron, that was a great defensive play by South Carolina. Again, the blitz. Maddox getting a hand on the football, the interception. But I'll tell you, I've seen a lot of great players in my day, but I've not seen anybody like Robert Edwards who got off the ground and saved this play from being a touchdown. The South Carolina very well may take this in for a score, but Robert Edwards is blocking on this play to protect Mike Bobo, number 47. Now you're going to see him step up. There he makes the block. Now he makes the second block. The ball's intercepted. Maddox hit the ball, and Robert Edwards tracking down, but now South Carolina's in great shape here with Deuce Staley in the running game.
Deuce will take it to around the 6-yard line. And Paul Beckwith, the starting center, number 53, is shaken up and is down. And you see him limping back to the huddle. But Jim Donnan knows that his ball club cannot afford to give up a touchdown right here.
Ron, in last year's game, Deuce Staley, you were talking about his teammate at junior college, Itawamba, Jason Ferguson. Jason Ferguson hit him on the first play of the game last year and then made a phone call to him after. Deuce Staley would like to make that same phone call and brag about his team after this one.
Staley, left side, that's a nice job defensively. Jason Ferguson comes up to hit his former teammate. In fact, Deuce goodbye to visit with him this summer, and he said Jason wasn't there, but his parents are such good friends, they fed me anyway.
I just wonder Jason didn't eat all the food. At 6'5", 305. Now you've got to be, Joe Kynes has got to be worried about Anthony Wright not only throwing the football here, but running the ball.
Third down, they can pick up a first down at the 1. Short drop, pass is incomplete. Ford with the cover, and Wright is not very happy with that one. In fact, again, his receiver had to knock the ball down so it wouldn't be picked off.
Ron, mark down this play. Robert Edwards getting off the ground and making the tackle on that interception may have saved 7 points.
You're right.
And that could be end up being big if Georgia ever quits making those mistakes. What a play by Robert Edwards. But that's the old defensive back. He was going to make that tackle.
That's right. Robert was voted in 1994 as the most promising defensive back. And Mike's exactly right. That's what he reacted like. Levitt's field goal attempt, and he's perfect. So there's a break in the action. We'll take it with him. 7:01 until halftime, and our new score, Carolina, 16-0. Now that's 16-0. It could very easily be 20-0, but the touchdown saving tackle by Edwards on the interception return of 58 yards by Washington. And so that's how we stand.
And South Carolina, to their credit and the coach's credit, played air free. I mean, they have not made the same type of mistakes mentally or dropping the ball that Georgia has this first half.
Levitt's kickoff is very high. It's not going to reach the end zone, but it's going to come down to pass. Over the 25 and out to the 27-yard line. Well, ESPN2 has the best in college football. 12:30 next week, Stanford will take on Wisconsin. Then at 5:30, Texas Tech does battle with these Georgia Bulldogs as you look at Hansbard run. And then at 8:30, the third part of the triple header, Syracuse tries to redeem itself against Minnesota. That's on the deuce next week, the triple header. Gets by one tackler. Going to take it up to the 35-yard line. And Mike Tirico, what fresh do you have for us now, my friend?
Well, Ron, when we last showed you Alabama, the interception for the touchdown made it 29-18. Here's what happened on the very next snap. Jason Donovan is hit by Fernando Davis. He fumbles. Bama recovers. Curtis Alexander runs it in. Late third quarter over on the deuce. The Bama lead is 18.
Boy, just to think, Mike, just 15 playing minutes ago, that thing was a dogfight. It was very, very tight. But Alabama now well in control. Georgia, they got to get something going. Edwards, he's been the guy so far, and you can see he crosses the first down marker as Arturo Freeman comes up from that free safety spot to make the hit off.
On South Carolina couldn't stop anybody last year on defense, a very young football team, and you might remember, the football fans might remember Darren Hamrick. He played for Florida and was booted off the football team. John Reeves got him here, but the coaches all said he brought a chemistry to this football team, this defense. He knows how to win, and the players listen to him.
A very emotional player, right? You can see in his career games at the University of Florida what he did. Play action under pressure, but was that a pass or is it a fumble? Matt Gentry says it is a fumble as Shane Burnett, the middle linebacker, got it.
Well, you could turn out the lights if they would have called that a fumble, because Mike Bobo just slow and not seeing the blitz coming and very, very close to being a fumble. Mike Bobo faking the sprint draw to the left. A busted assignment by Matt Stinchcomb. Close.
Well, the crowd is booing, but I think the officials are right on. His arm appeared to be coming forward as you look at Wally Burnham, who, of course, is the defensive coordinator here at South Carolina.
And that's Shane, number 52. That's his son. And for his father.
5'10", 222, a junior. Draw play. This is Kirksey. And look at this fella move. Ran right out of his shoe across midfield, and he's down to the 40-yard line as Freeman makes the stop.
The draw play has worked well for Georgia. The heavy rush of the South Carolina defensive line, that's how you slow them down, with draws, delays, and screens. Torin Kirksey's showing you his speed. What a double punch there. Give you a Robert Edwards who has speed and power, and then they bring in a quick back Kirksey.
Mike, you know, we've been talking about averages tonight. He's averaging 13.6 a carry. He had 20 the first time he carried it. 21 on that one. 16-0, South Carolina. Georgia trying to fight their way back into this one. Kirksey turns the corner, and he'll go for three. Mike Tirico, back to you. Gene's voice dropped 2 octaves on that one.
Ron, just thinking about Jim Donnan on the sideline, his coaching staff right now, he still has to feel pretty good about this thing. Only down 16-0, and like you said, it could have been over 3 scores, but if his team can punch the ball in here, I still like their chances in this ballgame of making it a very competitive game.
Right now, they could serve themselves well by having something positive happen just before halftime. Situation, they have a second down at about 6. The South Carolina 36. Zings the pass in there. That is complete to number 4, who's Small. Tony Small on the receiving end, and that'll be enough to move the chains.
In the first half, as we said, mistakes by Robert Edwards dropping the ball. Deuce Staley's had a great first half for South Carolina. And let's look at our graphic. Edwards has been on the field a little bit longer. 14 touches for Robert Edwards. They're close in yards, but that big touchdown, those 2 fumbles by Edwards, separates them tonight.
Mm-hmm. And, of course, as I mentioned, you know, Edwards lost 44 of those on that holding call to the pass. First down, Kirksey. Good leg drive as he pumps his way inside the 25 to the 23. Shane Burnham in the middle linebacking spot makes the hit on him. And the clock now becoming very important as far as the first half. About to go under 4 minutes.
When we talk about, watch Robert Edwards. He's going to step up here and block. Now you have a tailback. When you go to 2 backs now, you got 2 tailbacks in there, so you need one of them to block. Of course, Robert got pushed into that block by Torrey Kirksey, but he's not ashamed to block. All around back.
Georgia's got over 200 yards in total offense tonight and no points to show of it. Kirksey breaks it open. Better get a helmet on him at the 20, 10, 15, and let's make it the 5. And Hines Ward with an outstanding block in the play, and it is first and goal. They're going to put it down just outside the 3.
That was a draw play, too, but it's a bust draw. Somehow somebody went the wrong way, but Mike Bobo got the ball to Torin Kirksey, shows his speed again. Robert Edwards let him, and Terry Cousins makes the tackle. But to me right now, as I stand here watching that ball game, the biggest play in the first half was Robert Edwards' game, the saving tackle, that not allowing South Carolina to get that interception in for a touchdown.
Yep, you're right. Edwards. He'll take it to the 1. Kirksey, we've got for 70 yards already, as Patrick Garth makes the tackle on the play.
We better put him on our chart. Georgia had a tough time last week against Southern Mississippi inside the 20-yard line. You see, three tries last week. We couldn't get in there, so I'm sure Jim Donnan's thinking, hey, let's get this one in and get this thing before it snowballs on us so we start thinking about it inside the 20.
Before another disaster happens, which has been the case for him tonight. This is the 10th play of the drive. Edwards hit in the backfield, upended, and that's going to be Taylor. Henry Taylor, a three-year starter for the Gamecocks, and now situation for Georgia as the tension mounts across the way on that bench.
I tell you, I'd come right back with the same play, and Robert Edwards use his 203 pounds. I wouldn't pitch the ball out. I'd give it to Robert Edwards again and see if he could get it in. Shane Burnham, the coach's son, made a great play on that last one. He really got inside and underneath the offensive lineman.
Edwards. Touchdown, Georgia.
Ron, when you got a stallion, the secretariat, all those things, you give him the football. He eventually is going to get it into the paint in that end zone, and Robert Edwards has done that.
So with 2:05 left to play in this opening half, Georgia gets on the scoreboard, and they can cut it to a 9-point ball game. Langley, perfect with the extra point. One more look.
What made this play is about a yard and a half behind, Robert Edwards goes airbound. And even though he's hit by Benji Young, number 49, when you're 208 pounds and 6'2", and you get up in the air like that, it's going to be tough to stop you. Jim Donnan, well, just another day, right?
Believe you know me. He's here, finally. Yeah.
Believe me, he might say that outwardly, but his stomach's killing him right now. Here's our graphic again. 17 touches for Edwards. Now the touchdown dream. Look at those yards. But you made a good point. Kirksey, he's the other guy in this mix right now in the draw play for Georgia.
Well, Kirksey on six carries has got 70 yards. So all that fine-tuning you've done this week on defense to say stop 47, you also now got to keep an eye on number 20. Well, he showed he can kill you immediately.
It's a good point. You watch tape all week, and you say we got a key on 47. All of a sudden, this little speedster comes out of nowhere. But now it's Deuce Staley's time. He has had an excellent first half. Let's not forget that. And the blocking by South Carolina's offensive line to play the quarterback. We'll see if Deuce Staley can answer this young man, Robert Edwards. And he may get a chance on this kickoff.
Staley, one of the deep players for South Carolina as they await this Langley kickoff. And it's going to go to Staley's side from the 12. To the 21, Mike Tirico, back to you.
Ron, a reminder, coming up on the GMAC Halftime Report, we'll update the game in Alabama, 32-point third quarter between Vandy and the Tide. Chris Lee and Kirk will recap Michigan-Colorado 2, which also came down to a Hail Mary. And would a team go for two with the overtime rule? Well, somebody did, and you'll see what happened to East Carolina at halftime. See you in a few.
That's an interesting situation, Mike. We talked about that driving over to the stadium today. And some coaches who were against the overtime said, I thought that's the reason we had the two-point conversion. So,
well, some guys like the fact on the road of trying to end it right away. I would have gone into overtime, but Steve Logan knows his ball club a lot better than I do.
Deuce Staley. Folks, what you're seeing tonight are two guys that are so adept at what they do. Bailey and Jones combined on the stop, but that's a 16-yard gain right there.
And Joe Kynes is going to have to make some kind of adjustments at the half because Deuce Staley has had free rein against his defense in the first half.
Well, we saw Edwards limping just a moment ago, and now Deuce Staley limps off the field. He has 16 carries plus a couple of returns. The This is Moritz, who has just come into the lineup, and let's go down and check in with Kellen Winslow, who has an injury update for us. Kellen?
Ron and Mike, just before the half, the triple threat for Georgia, Ward went into the locker room, shoulder pads off. They were massaging his left shoulder early. It could be a burner, but they took him in early. We'll see what happens after the halftime.
Okay. And we saw them during that break checking over his shoulder over there, so undoubtedly he's got a little burner or something. So we'll find out more. One timeout left for South Carolina as we go under 1 minute to play. Staley crosses midfield and he's down to the 48.
Staley.
Chris Terry, defensively for Georgia.
Chris Terry knew it was going to be a pass to Deuce Staley, but he got too much penetration, was able to come off to make the tackle, but there's another way Deuce Staley hurts you, catching the football. Remember, he's a former wide receiver that has turned to be a tailback now. John Easton, the offensive coordinator, says, I keep checking how many times he touches the ball. I want his hands on the football.
He'll take it for a three-yard gain as Jermaine Smith wraps him up at the 45-yard line. Coming up at halftime, the GMAC Halftime Report. Number 11, Michigan against number 5, Colorado down to the wire. Vandy and Alabama, we'll talk more about that. And East Carolina, West Virginia, that's that game where they went for two rather than going to the overtime. That's what Mike was talking about. So we'll have that and more coming up on the GMAC Halftime Report.
And Ron, we've had two great running backs tonight performance, and next week we're going to see another one. Kevin Falk of LSU.
Yes. Boy, that's for sure. That's where we'll be. Last week, Falk against Houston, 246 yards, two rushing touchdowns, and a 78-yard touchdown on a punt return. His ball club at home in front of 80,000 people, Mike, was down by 20 points, and it came back and beat Houston by one. And, of course, Auburn this afternoon looked very strong against Ole Miss down in Oxford.
And here are our runners tonight. Robert Edwards getting a checkup. Deuce Staley will be back on the field here in a second. But now South Carolina has a little bit of a problem with 23 seconds now. They've got to be able to throw the ball to the corners outside or with the rule of stopping the clock with a first down. That helps them. They've got to be ready for a second play.
You know, Mike, if Deuce Staley can throw a halfback pass, student body might come after him. I mean, if they've got it, it might not be a bad place to throw it in.
Not in this situation. If they throw any kind of pass over these defensive backs, as deep as they are right now, it'll be trouble for Georgia.
Bailey with the cover on Robinson. Well, Anthony Wright has had an outstanding first half. He has shown a lot of poise, and you would not believe that this is only his second start in his first in the Southeastern Conference, but he has been very, very calm. Wright and Zola Davis are roommates, and Zola said yesterday he's been pretty relaxed. Swings this one out to Staley. There's a block in the back, and flags come from everywhere, so they're going to take an extreme walk back here because I don't know if it was Zola that threw that block or not, but it was a block in the back, and you could see three flags come in immediately.
10 yards disqualified.
Both defensive coordinators are going to go in at halftime, and they're going to look at these charts, and they're going to say, we missed too many tackles. Look at the tackles broken by Edwards and Staley in this first half. That means poor tackling, poor positioning, poor technique, and that's something both Wally Burnham and Joe Kynes are going to stress in the second half. We need to bring these guys down. You see Joe Kynes, and he will talk about bringing Deuce Staley down.
So the situation, no timeouts left, and the clock has run down to 0-0. So it is halftime. That's the end of the first half of their score. South Carolina 16, Georgia 7. Now let's join Mike Tirico for the GMAC Halftime Report. The area that they call the zone, they are extremely pleased tonight. A lot of food and beverage there. 16-7 our score. South Carolina leading at halftime. And Mike, the two guys we talked about off the top of the telecast, the two tailbacks, have really put on a clinic tonight.
Well, they really have. They've had a great half. And we're going to look at those highlights right after the kick.
So we're set to get it underway in the second half of play as Georgia will get the football back. Levitt to kick it off for South Carolina. From the six. Mike, let's take a look at those highlights from the first half.
We talked, Ron, about the duel between the tailbacks. Deuce Staley's going to take off for 51 yards against a pretty good Georgia defense. But look at his head on the swivel, always looking for the defender that he has to beat. Great cutting ability. This is a great play at the first half. That's Robert Edwards on the ground. He just made a block. The ball's intercepted by Ben Washington. All of a sudden, Robert Edwards gets up. Now, he stops as he's a former defensive back, a former corner, and makes a good tackle. That saved the touchdown. And then he came back over the top using his 202 pounds for a touchdown.
Back to live action as you look at Kirksey. Caldwell comes over to get a piece of him as you look at Staley on the sideline. And seeing Kirksey as we open this second half of play, you have to wonder about that injury to Edwards' leg. And the fact that Kellen was able to speak with Jim Donnan just as they came back out in the second half after this play, we'll get that interview lined up for you. Second down. Line to make is the 34. Pass just overthrown, and let's go down to Kellen Winslow. Kellen?
Rod and Mike, I talked to Coach Donnan coming in right up before the third quarter. He said that they were their own worst enemy, that they had moved the ball down the field. He was pleased with that, but they just kept shooting themselves in the foot. He talked about the injury updates with Hines Ward. They're watching his shoulder. Not sure what they're going to do with him. And Edwards also with the bruised knee. As you see, he's not in the ball game right now.
John, I would expect Juan Daniels has to step up big here eventually. He's a senior receiver. He had 46 receptions last year. You would expect Mike Bobo to try to find Juan Daniels in the clutch.
Well, the third down situation, Georgia 3-5 on the night.
Dead ball, false start, offense.
As they mark off the penalty, let's show you the numbers from the first 30 minutes of play. 224 to 204 in total yardage, but look down at the bottom number, turnovers.
You don't have to look far when you look at the turnovers, three by Georgia, and still we're 16-7, and they're still alive to tell about it.
And also Georgia 67 snaps to 32. But South Carolina has taken care of business. They have been very, very efficient. Bubba's pass is caught, and the man that Mike was just talking about. So check it, Hines Ward, I beg your pardon, good for 28 yards in the pass play.
He was drafted out of high school as a center fielder by the Marlins, and he shows you what a good athlete he is, Hines Ward, just working down the middle against two deep coverage. Number 19, Hines Ward, just finding a hole, and Mike Bobo with someone in his face
Pennington.
Throwing that football. Pennington right in his face just stood in there and made that completion.
So just like that, Georgia across midfield. Kirksey hit in the backfield, and he's got to be knocked down by Henry Taylor. And Henry got penetration immediately to foul that one up.
Ron, they're not the same offensive team without Robert Edwards. Now, Torin Kirksey's a good back, but he's not like Robert Edwards. And when you got them both in there, that gives you so much ability. Now, with Edwards out of the ballgame and on the sidelines until he returns, the pressure goes to Mike Bobo, the junior quarterback. And I keep saying, Juan Daniels, number 12, is a receiver that has so much experience with Georgia offense.
And second and 12, zings it, incomplete. Ward, the intended receiver, and Lee Wiggins with very good close coverage on the play.
Bobo's pass intended for Hines Ward. Wiggins coverage.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
135 yards, an average of almost 8 per try. But he's on the bench as he got a little nick, an injury to his knee. Don't know exactly when we will see him again in the second half. Georgia. And they need the South Carolina 39-yard line. Bobo's pass thrown behind Hines Ward. Washington, the closest man there on the cover, and they're going to have to punt it away.
Good pressure again by Henry Taylor. Wally Vernon, the defensive coordinator, calling the right defenses. Henry Taylor had the best preseason of all the defensive linemen for South Carolina. He's putting the rush on Mike Bobo.
Corey Bridges back deep to accept this punt from Langley. Backs a junior out of Conyers, Georgia. Bridges with a fair catch at the 21. So let's take a timeout. 12:46 left third quarter. Our score remains 16-7 Carolina. This is provided by Kroger Food Stores Blimp, the spirit of Atlanta. Did you know that a Blimp specially mounted aerial camera can shoot a picture that zooms at a 45-1 zoom? There you go. Huh. Oh, what a great night. Temperature's supposed to be into the 50s. Very clear. But if you're a South Carolina fan, it has been just perfecto night. Georgia still trying to get it on track. As Deuce Staley with the first carry, hit by Tootle, senior out of Atlanta.
Here's the rush chart for Deuce Staley tonight. And what this doesn't show you, it shows you the right side, 5 for 77, and the left side. But what Deuce Staley does such a good job of is cutting back against the grain. His offensive line's zone blocking. He's cutting back away from linebackers. Just does a nice job on cuts.
Well, Champ Bailey in the ballgame, number 42. And, of course, Ronnie Bailey is the starter at right corner, number 5. Play action. Holds on to it forever and it makes it work perfectly, except the ball was dropped by his roommate, Zola Davis. That was Snellings who was coming on the rush after him.
Well, Snelling did a better job, Ron, on this play, trying to keep containment on Anthony Wright. He did not let him outside of him. And that's what you have to do as a defensive end. He was a defensive tackle after Paul Snelling made the move in spring to defensive end.
South Carolina, 2 of 7 on third down conversions. Here they come with a blitz in the corner. Steps up and drills it right over the middle. Going to be good for the first down. And Zola Davis went back probably and said to his roommate, hey, I dropped the last one. Throw it to me again. I'm going to show you how he can bring that thing in.
Well, Zola Davis, he caught 59 passes last year. Doesn't have great speed, but runs great routes. But what happens here is Georgia with a blitz on. See the linebacker, Greg Bright, on the blitz. It was picked up very well. Good protection. Anthony Wright with the catch, with the throw, and Zola Davis with the catch.
Well, he dropped that one a moment ago. That really most unlike him. Has extremely sure hands. Jermaine Smith messes that one up. Maybe a gain of one. Kellen Winslow, what do you have for us, partner?
Well, Ron and Mike, we're just talking about Zola Davis and what he did his first year here at South Carolina, and it puts him in good company with Robert Brooks. 34 receptions, 508 yards, 4 touchdowns. He even beat the great Sterling Sharp, one of our colleagues. Only 32 receptions, 421 yards, and only 2 TDs. We gave Sterling a little trouble about that yesterday.
He's probably sitting in Bristol right now, turning the TV off and on again.
Zola has said that Sterling is one that he really likes to pattern himself after, though. And he said because he's such a physical player. Staley's hit in the backfield. Jermaine Smith will knock him down for a loss. And boy, that hasn't happened many times tonight, with Staley not picking up positive yardage.
Ron, Jermaine Smith, and now you want to stop a running back, you get penetration. Jermaine Smith came off the football and makes this hit. I mean, he just is going to blast through this hole and get penetration. Watch him just explode against the center, Paul Beckwith, and he's in the backfield to stop Deuce Staley.
It's only the second time that Georgia has stopped him for a loss tonight. It is third down, and they need their own 45 to keep this thing going. Good pressure from the outside, and here's where he can kill you. He can run with the football, and that's a good open field stop by Greg Wright.
Greg Bright was a linebacker and tight end in high school, but he did what he had to do right there. You're exactly right, Ron. He broke down on the play, and when you have to make that open field tackle on Anthony Wright, that's so important. He was able to stop that ball from possibly becoming a first down, because if he misses that tackle, Anthony Wright goes down the football field.
New return guy with the injury to Hines Ward, Chris McCraney, number 23. Really good kick here. McCraney to the 20, 25, and it's going to be jerked down from behind. So there's a timeout on the field. It's a 45-yard kick as the Georgia defense takes a well-deserved breather. Edwards is back in the ballgame. Fake it to him. Get the pass out to Brown, the tight end, and he will take it for the first down. And Mike Tirico, what do you have for us?
Well, this McDonald's breakaway run takes us to Amon Carter Stadium. TCU at home against Kansas, and June Henley taking it to the end zone. 10-yard run, he passes Tony Sands, all-time TD leader at Kansas with 29. Up 7 on the deuce over there, and we welcome those of you SEC fans who watched Bama hold on to beat Vandy by 10, also on the deuce.
You know, Mike, Kansas trying to help the Big 12 hold up their head against the WAC because they're down 3-1 in games coming into today. Edwards, little counter play, gets one block, cannot get by Hambrick. Darren Hambrick manhandles him and knocks him down, number 18.
We're talking about the chemistry of this South Carolina defense. You got to take your hats off to them tonight. They played well. And Darren Hambrick is the reason. Wally Vernon was telling me the story of it last fall practice, that one of the offensive players, South Carolina, scored a touchdown, 50-yard touchdown play against this defense. And Hambrick chased him into the end zone and throughout the end zone. And when he turned around, he didn't see a teammate near him. And he went off the sideline and he chewed him out. He said, you know, you can't play defense like that. We need to all run to the football. And he just brought something special to this defense.
And I mentioned in the first half, he's a very emotional player. But you're right, Mike. It's an infectious thing as you look at the upper left of your frame in the picture, number 18. Bubba's picture. Going to be intercepted. Middle linebacker Shane Burnham watched the receiver and simply did not pick up Burnham, who had just dropped into coverage.
And Mike Bobo took too long to just look up his receiver here. And Shane Burnham, the son of the coach, the defensive coordinator, Wally, made this interception. Wally didn't discourage him from playing on the same team that he coached. He said it puts a lot of pressure on Shane, but those kind of plays will take the pressure off.
Well, we're just talking about the play of Darren Hambrick and the South Carolina defense. And an example right there that they are playing with great emotion and probably have been underrated in this football game so far tonight. Right pass right over the middle. Deuce Staley. Corey Johnson finally got him, but that is a gain of 19 yards. And this crowd just loves it. You hear the deuce.
They're not talking about ESPN's two either. Deuce Staley with the just pass over the middle. Poor tackle right here. Now Deuce Staley's loose in the secondary. Corey Johnson's going to make that play, but that's what makes him difficult. He runs the football, but his receiving ability catching the ball in the backfield.
Well, they give it to him again. You see the quick short cutback. It's Travis Stroud. We'll stop him after a couple of yards. Mike Tirico, you're a busy guy tonight.
Yeah, Ron, our Sandlot Award of the night goes to Tom Rossley and SMU's coaching staff. Punt formation against Utah. Watch this. He just threw the ball downfield, not to a receiver, but I guess the punt returner didn't know if it was a punt or a pass. So he said, hey, I'm not going to knock it down. I'll take it back. And he fumbled, and SMU got the ball. Tight game there, Utah up 7.
You know what can happen on that play, Ron? That can be pass interference if they're blocking your outside guys. That's a great play.
Bailey makes the catch, falls forward as Corey Johnson. Yeah, that's really unusual. Really, really unusual.
Here's our matchup tonight. The two running backs. Edwards has a couple, a little bit more time than Staley. Staley's getting the ball a little bit more now. Of course, Robert Edwards was injured. 202, the touches for Deuce Staley, getting up there to 26. They wanted to be 25-plus tonight.
Greg Bright, number 45. was an outside linebacker. They moved him inside, and he's played well for them. They normally throw a shovel pass off that, throws it to the end zone, and just missed Zola Davis. You could see the back coming inside, though, and we watched him work on that in practice, where when he rolls out, they will also throw the shovel pass.
That's a Bill Walsh play right there, misdirection play, and Anthony Wright just hurried to throw, but he had him wide open. He had Staley open for a first down. He had Zola Davis open for the touchdown. Let's watch Deuce Staley come out of the backfield. There's the good fake. He's open for the first down. Now getting the ball, he's got the first down. But I don't blame him for where he threw the ball because he had a touchdown down the field. He just overthrew it.
Well, let's see what the freshman can do here. This is going to be an attempt of 47 yards. In high school, he had kicks of 62, 60, and 58. Good pass. You see, he's got a great leg, but does he have direction? Hit the post. Wide left. So let's take a break. 16-7. Caroline on top. We'll be right back. We're back at Williams-Brice Stadium in Columbia, South Carolina. Ron Franklin, Mike Gottfried, and Kellen Winslow. Just under six to play, third quarter. Carolina by nine. And Edwards back in the ballgame. And Mike, when he came back in during the timeout, he was running and working on his cutting, wasn't he?
He has some problem that's caused him not to be able to cut right now.
Carolina showing blitz. Let's see if they come or not. Obviously, Bobo in the middle of changing his play. Stop and go. Got him out there. And caught, but he stay in bounds. There's the man we were just talking about, Juan Daniels, and they got it to him.
Ron, for Georgia to win this football game, we're going to put up a graphic here in a second, but for them to win the football game, if Robert Edwards is hurt, Hines Ward's nicked a little bit, Juan Daniels now has one touch of the football for 30 yards. He is the valuable receiver. He's the veteran, so you expect him to carry the load when the running game gets hurt a little bit. So I expect Juan Daniels to become a bigger factor as we go in the 5:49 mark of the third quarter.
Juan Daniels last year caught 726 yards worth of passes and five touchdowns. Draw play, catches. Hit in the backfield by Burnham, and he will get back to the line of scrimmage, but that is it.
We had this South Carolina team last year against Florida, and it was a track meet. Florida won the discus, shot put. They won everything. And I can remember walking out of here, and we talked about Wally Burnham, who's a former assistant of Bobby Bowden at Florida State, and they were undermanned. Well, they may still be undermanned a little bit, but they're playing so much better. And Wally Burnham and his defensive staff, you've got to give them credit for the effort that South Carolina's making on defense.
Second down and 10. The line of scrimmage just inside the South Carolina 39. As Brad Stafford is over the football, number 65. Bobo's pass, incomplete. He caught it out of bounds. You know, the man we were just talking about a moment ago, Hambrick, number 18, I want to make one other point about him. He may be as good an athlete as the state of Florida has seen in a long time, Mike, because he made All-State in three sports, in basketball, in track, and in football. In one year, in the state track meet, his team scored 27 points. He had 25 of them. In the high jump, he high jumped 7-1 and 1/4.
Wow.
And he's a linebacker now. That is an unbelievable athlete.
And the reason South Carolina got him is John Reeves recruited him to Florida and then recruited him here after he changed jobs.
You see the third down conversions. They throw back on the screen. Hines Ward, whoa, does he put a head down, and that's Arturo Freeman that he reversed the charges on. Stinchcomb with a very good block out front.
Little semi-row to the left by Mike Bobo, a nice call here by George on offense. They're going to set the screen up to Hines Ward over here. He's going to back up, and then he's going to get both linemen out here for block, and Mike Bobo's going to move to the left. Here's the snap, move to the left, draw everybody in. There's Hines Ward now, the good block by Stinchcomb and Fleming. And Arturo Freeman makes the tackle.
First down play. Edwards right up the middle. Has five, has ten. Inside the 10-yard line, and he's down to the four. First and goal, Georgia Bulldogs. 22 yards from scrimmage on the run by Robert Edwards.
Well, so much for the cutting ability. Worrying about that because he was moving in that hole. But he looks like he's gliding a Herschel Walker type back for Georgia. Hampton, all the great backs they've had, he just glides through that line of scrimmage and just an amazing athlete. Ben Washington makes the tackle.
Mike, it looks as though they have put a sleeve, they have, on at left leg of his. Edwards eyeing the goal line. Oh, does he get punished on this play, though? Burnham, the first man there, and also Rory Gallman.
Ron, give Ray Goff credit for making that switch of Robert Edwards. He moved him after spring practice, after the spring game, matter of fact, and on the first carry, he carried the ball 50 yards for a touchdown, and he was a former defensive back for Joe Kynes, and Joe Kynes leaned over to one of the assistants. He said, we've seen the last of him on defense.
Yeah. Well, you know, as I mentioned in the first half, in 1994, he was voted as the most promising defensive back. But they saw what he could do with the football, and the rest is history. As Fritzy comes in, calling a sophomore out of Jacksonville, Florida. Fake it to him, looking for the tight end in the end zone, throws it, touchdown. He found Juan Daniels open as the tight end Brown was covered.
Juan Daniels, what a touchdown.
Juan Daniels steps up to make that catch.
Hey, Miss
we've
Neal,
got our ball game.
How are you?
And he has the presence of mind to say hello to somebody after scoring a touchdown.
Larry Brown is the man they wanted initially, number 87, and South Carolina was holding him up. And Daniels got free in the end zone for the touchdown. Max Langley with the extra point, and a flag is down, so let's hold it for a second and check it out.
Being a late substitution, South Carolina, and I don't know whether he actually got onside.
Defense, offside. Be penalized on the kickoff.
What number?
Near Henry Taylor said, what number?
I can tell you, it was 13. Here's the touchdown. Good play action by Mike Bobo. Sells the fake to Kirksey. Now the tight end, Larry Brown's not open. He was able to go inside, threw it behind Juan Daniels. What a great catch by Juan Daniels.
The crowd tonight, and right now they are the quietest they have been all evening. It is a new record for Williams-Brice Stadium, 82,950. And boy, are they seeing a ball game. 16-14 our numbers. Carolina up by a couple with 3:30 to play third quarter.
Juan Daniels had two big catches on that drive from Mike Bobo.
Wally Burnham on the sideline, talking it over with his defense. With a couple of really good running plays, Edwards and Kirksey, and then the pass at the goal line, and Georgia is on the board again, as you can see Bobo on the sideline also trying to pump up that offense. Craig Ford, number 26, to kick it off for the Bulldogs. And we have Cousin, along with Staley, back at the 10-yard line. So they will take it on a knee and bring it out to the 20-yard line. And Mike, you know what stands out in my mind right now? This ball game could be completely different. This play right here on the interception.
Well, there's no doubt this was the biggest play in the first half as far as I was concerned, because it saved a touchdown and kept South Carolina to a field goal. Robert Edwards off the ground. He just made a good block. Now he comes back and makes the tackle on Ben Washington and saves the touchdown, forced him to a field goal.
So that's 4 points that South Carolina didn't come up with. Would be 20-14 right now. He never gets tired of working. He said he'll carry it 30, 35 times, and you can see him continue to spin and twist. Champ Bailey finally put the stopper on him, number 42.
Well, they're proud of him at Itawamba Junior College because he was a wide receiver there for them, and as Kellen Winslow said, he grew up right here in Columbia, so he's back home in front of home folks and giving this man a headache.
What number he wore in junior college, and he got a big grin, and he said two. Okay. 22 here at South Carolina as he gets to the game. Going to be spun down by Bright, and let's check in with Kellen Winslow. Kellen.
Ron and Mike, I talked to Deuce just a couple of minutes ago after that last South Carolina series. He said, how do you feel? He says he feels strong. He can carry the ball another 20 times if he had to.
You know, Kellen, I think one of the things that really has helped him is the fact that I mentioned in the first half he has dropped 15 pounds. He has very little fat on his body. I think, you know, maybe he's more durable.
He is more durable. He's really tightened up from when I saw him last year. He looks great out there. Kind of reminds me of a little Barry Sanders, a little Emmitt Smith.
Yeah, he's got some moves. Second down, blitz in the middle. That's about the only way you stop him is Corey Johnson came up and knocked him down along with Kirby Smart. And that's just take his wheels out from under it.
Now, Ron, the pressure kind of shifts a little bit to number one, Anthony Wright. Now, he has to make a play. Mike Bobo made some plays on his last drive. Now you got to take a little heat off your running back and make the completion or run for the first down.
Well, if Carolina doesn't take it around the 41-yard line, this drive is over. They are 3 of 10 in third down conversions tonight. Wright coming in the middle on the blitz. They got him. The ball is loose, and it was recovered by Wheeler, number 75.
He's going to call him down.
Down at the 22-yard line. So Georgia stands to get very good field position out of this exchange as McCraney goes back deep.
No time for Anthony Wright. Good call by Joe Kynes getting the blitz in the middle. Greg Bright is the first one to show up.
Kick very, very high. Good coverage kick here. McCraney does not call for a fair catch, and the Carolina players were so close to him they had to run by him. Now, ESPN2 has the best in college football as well. Next Saturday, 12:30, Stanford takes on Wisconsin. Then at 5:30, the second part of the doubleheader, you get to see Hans Part and company, Texas Tech, battling these same Georgia Bulldogs. And then at 8:30, Syracuse tries to redeem itself against Minnesota, all next Saturday on the Deuce.
We had Syracuse last week. They will redeem themselves. They're going to still have a good football team this year. Got caught in a tough opener.
Carolina might make living hard on a number of teams this year. Bobo hangs it over the middle. Wiggins with the cover got a hand on it. It was Corey Allen who he wanted. Coming up later in the game, we'll be selecting the Visa Players of the Game. I know a couple of guys now, got a head start.
Hey, that shouldn't be too tough a job tonight. Darren Hambrick just keeps coming on defense. He brings an attitude with him. He wants to win. He wants this program to be like the program he left in the SEC.
Another young fellow who has had a good ball game tonight is Henry Taylor, number 90. Big defensive tackle for Carolina. Bobo play action, wants to go on top, looking for the end zone, and it is overthrown at the 10-yard line as Cousin was covering on the play, and Bobo went down pretty hard.
Errol Rochester, number 57. Wally Burnham doing a nice job of substituting, keeping fresh people, putting pressure on the quarterback. Mike Bobo went down. Just put too much air under that football. Remember the screen pass that they've had success with to Hines Ward. They've run it two times. One for a touchdown was brought back. Another for a key first down.
Carolina crowd asking for a stop. Flags are down.
I think they're going to get them for delay of game. Now that where that been thrown, maybe.
Dead ball. 25-second clock. It expired before the snap. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Can't have those mistakes, Ron. They've made so many mistakes tonight, the Georgia Bulldogs.
John Abraham, number 95, checks into the ball game. He's the true freshman, one of the guys that we've talked about tonight, only played 1 year of high school football. Just talking about it, the ball is knocked away, and he got pressure on him as Freeman knocked the ball away, and Abraham knocked his head gear off.
Too much pressure again on Mike Bobo, trying to get the ball to Hines Ward on a corner route. Freeman really played it well. Played the last year as a freshman. Here's the pressure on Mike Bobo. Tries to come outside, gets hit as he throws. There's the defensive play by Freeman, number 12. Good coverage on Hines Ward. He's open, just couldn't get him the ball.
That's very good athleticism there.
Timeout, South Carolina. I don't think they had enough people on the field again and made a timeout call. Players made it.
So with 29 seconds left in this third quarter, let's go back and check in with Mike Tirico. Mike.
All right, Ron, let's check everyone in on that game over on the Deuce. Kansas had a 7-0 lead on the June Henley touchdown. Here comes John Williams, one of the six tailbacks listed on the TCU roster. 59-yard touchdown, the tide at 7, early second.
Good ball game in Eamon Carter tonight, Fort Worth. Freeman, who made that play just a moment ago. We also need to mention, we said in the first quarter that he has the reputation of being a hitter. But, Mike, he was a former wide receiver in high school. And, in fact, his senior year had 107 receptions, which is extreme. And then you take and make a defensive back out of him. And going with the left hand and knocking that ball away there, that you can see why.
Well, he's got good athletic ability, like you said. A lot of those receivers played defensive back in high school. And he played last year as a true freshman here, so he's got some experience.
Bobo being attended to and an injury to his right hand. Langley, they almost got it. As a result, a short kick, but it goes out of bounds at the 27, so there's no return. And we have 21 ticks left on the clock following that 34-yard kick. ESPN's coverage of Major League Soccer continues on Tuesday with New England against DC United. DC United has already secured a playoff spot. Coverage begins Tuesday, 7:30 Eastern, here on ESPN.
I'll find a way to open this series with Deuce Staley. Get him the ball again.
Take the draw. Deep set in the pocket, and that pass nicely caught by Bridges. Champ Bailey, 42, is there to make the hit. And it looks as though Bridges is hurt, right?
Yeah, everybody's so conscious of the draw play, and when you fake the draw, the linebackers, everybody's stepping up, and that opens that area behind for a curl for Corey Bridges.
I don't know if it's an ankle or a knee, but he's really hobbling down on the sideline. And that is the end of the third quarter, so we'll take a timeout with our score. Carolina 16, Georgia 14. So we're back for the final quarter, 16-14, South Carolina on top. And let's take a look at the backs and how they stand as you look at Robert Edwards on the sideline. 158 to 214 as far as touches. Now the Deuce with 29. Nine more than Edwards.
And they're making the final turn, heading to home.
Pass caught near sideline, just across midfield. And Bailey will knock Marcus Robinson out of bounds. Now, you got to respect Robinson because he is 6'4", and he's a track guy who runs the 200. He had a 53-yard touchdown reception last week.
Well, there's two things that's making this tough for Georgia defensively. First of all, the threat of Staley and the good play action fake by Anthony Wright, that's opening up this pass game right now. Good mix in this offense by John Eason, the offensive coordinator tonight. And Wright has been impressive, Ron.
He really has. Doesn't look like a fellow just starting in his second game at quarterback. goes down, and boy, that's thrown by the umpire, so probably we got offensive holding. And we're going to be looking at a first down and 20 for South Carolina. Smith grabbing.
And where that flag is thrown, I think it's 5 yards further back,
yeah.
So it's going to go back a little bit more than that.
Holding on the offense, 10 yards, we're small to foul. It'll remain first down.
That's what makes it difficult. You pick up another 5 yards.
You're right, Mike. In fact, it's about a 16-and-a-half-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. So,
well, those penalties drive you crazy. You haven't had a holding call all night, and then you get one in the fourth quarter.
That offensive line has done a very good job. Nesbitt, Whitfield, Beckwith, Rubiak, Randy Wheeler. But they got caught on that one, so they go shotgun. Double screen. Nixon, the fullback, who normally is a blocker, caught the screen. Sight saved a huge play.
You got to love the call, and this is the reason this call works, is you're going to watch this play. Deuce Staley's right here. He's going to go out this way, and the fullback, Nixon's going to come out this way. Well, everybody thinks it's going to be a screen to Deuce Staley. Anthony Wright takes the football, fakes to Deuce Staley, and guess what? It's coming the other way to Steve Nixon. There's no one over here. You're right. Trey Sipes stopped the big gainer.
So it's a gain of 20, and just like that, South Carolina says, second down and about 7. Make this thing something reasonable. Got this pass. Bridges, that answers the question. He took him out of the game and checked his ankle, but he's hobbling a little bit, but he made a good cut right there in the reception. It's going to be third down and short.
Well, this is a big third down play for this Georgia defense, too. They need to stop this South Carolina offense right now. And the way John Easton's calling this game right now, he's taking a little pressure off Deuce Staley and putting it on Anthony Wright, and he's delivering. John, also a former Bobby Bowden assistant.
So it's third down. They need the 38-and-a-half-yard line to get this first down. Anthony Wright wants to throw it. Does. Connects to Zola Davis. First and 10, South Carolina.
That's a great play calling by John Easton, John Reeves, Brad Scott. When everybody's expecting a run, you get a little back route here, number 21, Zola Davis. Good play fake. Everybody in the ballpark's thinking Deuce Staley, and then you get the pass.
Mike, do you remember the hit that Zola absorbed last year early in the ballgame? Corey Johnson knocked him into the next county. And Zola said yesterday, I'll never forget that. He said, he cleaned my clock the way it had never been cleaned before. Then he came on and had a huge night, caught 2 touchdown passes. Tirico, let's go back and check in with you.
Well, Ron, down 21-7, Texas A&M is coming back at Southwestern Louisiana. Here's Brandon Stewart, kind of overshadowed when Texas A&M's defensive secondary played so poor in the opener against A&M. Stewart gets it down, fumbles the ball, but Steve McKinney fell on it for the touchdown. They missed the point, so they're down 2.
And the thrill for that offensive lineman.
You know Southwest Louisiana loves having A&M come to their place.
I was a little surprised. I thought that might have been a mistake on the schedule, but it obviously was not. Right over the middle, almost picked off. It's 27. The man we were just talking about, Corey Johnson, almost came up with a huge step.
Corey Johnson's had some big interceptions in this, and he should have had that football. He was reading it all the way. The pass over the middle, just out of the hands of Corey Johnson. Almost a great interception.
Wright is 8 of his last 10. And on this third down and 10, they go from the shotgun. Pressure up the middle. Throws to the end zone. Nice defensive play by Champ Bailey as Bridges for a moment had gotten behind him.
Well, a lot of defensive backs will stop when they think that quarterback's broken contain and going to run the football. Champ Bailey would not. His twin brother on the other side, Ronald Bailey, is the starting corner on the other side. But watch number 42. First of all, good pressure by Georgia's defense. Now Anthony Wright throwing the ball in the corner. But Champ Bailey makes a big-time play to keep that ball away from Corey Bridges.
And it came down and hit him in the stomach after he got tipped. 50 yards on this attempt. He's got plenty of distance, and he is no good off to the left. Timeout. 12:03 to play in our ball game. Carolina by two. Effort by Champ Bailey. If that ball had been thrown just another yard further, it might have been six, Carolina.
That's a big pass. He's a twin brother. Ronald Bailey is wrong. He's his brother.
Yeah. Just as much love.
That's right.
Bobo, broken play, and he is going to be hit by Maynard Caldwell and knocked down for a loss. Third time tonight that they have stopped him behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, you don't know whose mistake that was, whether Mike Bobo came out the wrong way. I have a feeling the running back may have gone the wrong way. Robert Edwards, just one of the two, makes the bust there and puts you in second and long. Still waiting for him to come back to that screen play to Hines Ward also.
So Edwards goes out of the ball game. Kurtzy had his arm hit at the line of scrimmage. That is Henry Taylor, who we were just talking about a moment ago, who's had a fine ball game. And it goes incomplete, and now it's third down, Georgia. Well, college football on ABC Sports next Saturday begins with a national game at noon. Number 9, Notre Dame against number 7, Texas. Followed by regional coverage at 3:30. Boston College at Michigan, Georgia Tech at North Carolina, and Arizona at Washington. This crowd is coming to their feet. 82,000 strong on this third down and 10 for the Bulldogs. Draw play, and he will not have it. Crow with a hit in the secondary. Henry Taylor, one of the first men to grab him, and then Rochester helped finish him off.
Earl Rochester's made some big plays tonight. He's a freshman, 5'11", 236 pounds, and gets the ball back for his offense.
And listen to this crowd for the defense. Big Henry Taylor comes to the sideline. Langley to kick it away. Boy, this is the best punt of the night. Bridges all the way back to the 16-yard line, and he will have nothing on the return. That's a 46-yarder. So there's a timeout on the field. 16-14, Gamecocks will be right back. Now there's the situation. 10 minutes and 37 seconds left in our ball game. South Carolina 16-14. Now for this man right here, how big is this ball game? How big is it for Brad Scott, the South Carolina head coach? Now this one would be just gigantic for the Gamecocks. Deuce Taylor. Gonna take it for a couple of yards. It's Jason Ferguson who is holding on to him. Brad Scott, they have done
Ferguson,
a lot as far as changing, improving facilities, and of course recruiting is paramount to this football team. You saw the beginning tonight. These people want so badly for this club to be good and for them to win. And tonight would be a giant step, Mike.
Big win, and you talk about the expansion here of what they've done. Mike McGee built new offices, the AD for the coaching staff, also put a big room in for the boosters. They are really moving here.
And they responded. You know, I mean, we said a new record crowd, 82,250. Oh, what a move by Wright. And he chooses not to throw it away. He's going to take the loss as Ferguson was all over him.
Ron, the reason that play broke down is they kept contained, finally, the defensive ends. They did not allow Anthony Wright to get outside. Then the receivers for South Carolina did not adjust and come back to him to try to help him out. He had nowhere to go with the ball.
So it's third down. It's a loss of two. And to keep this thing going, they've got to take the ball just out across the 26 at a half-yard line. I'm a little surprised he didn't just throw that out of bounds, not to lose the yardage.
That's the youth in the quarterbacks.
Zola Davis, number 21, working against Corey Johnson. That's quite a matchup right there. Georgia can't hold on to him. Still running. Gets a block, and he'll have the first down out across the 30-yard line. Deuce Staley was one of those who helped save his quarterback and threw a block for a 16-yard gain.
Anthony Wright becomes like a running back on this play. They had him. They had him trapped. Big first down, Ron.
Well, that's what I was talking about. That's what Joe Kine said last night. This kid forces you to defend all 11 players because of that right there. Just under 10 minutes to play. South Carolina by two. Right deep over the middle. It is almost intercepted, and Kirby Smart had it, and then he dropped it. And he can't believe it.
It's one of those games you're going to go back on as a coaching staff and look and say, well, if we'd have done this, or we'd have done this, or we wouldn't have done this, we'd have won this football game. Again, good play fake to D. Staley. Throw should have been picked off. Zola Davis, the intended receiver. Kirby Smart, almost with a big interception, stepped in front of Zola Davis. Remember, Staley can come out of the backfield as a receiver also.
Anthony Wright, the redshirt sophomore, sets in the pocket. That's Staley. Got him on the run. Breaks one tackle, and he will go across the 45 as Champ Bailey and Greg Bright combine on the stop, and it's a gain of 14.
That's what makes it so tough, because you've got a mismatch. You've got linebackers versus Deuce Staley. And Deuce Staley can work out of the backfield. He was open early in the ball game, and the South Carolina coach may have logged this one to come back to in a key situation, but then after he catches the football, big yardage.
First and 10, South Carolina. They own it at their own 46-yard line, and the clock now about to go under 9 minutes in this contest. Staley, you see Georgia trying to grab away the football. They can't do it. Brian Jones in the stop. That was big Jermaine Smith, 98, trying to rip it apart.
You and Kellen both mentioned the strength and the good shape that Deuce Staley is in. He has played this entire football game. And he's made so many touches on that football tonight, catching the football, returning kicks, and running the football. And he has been such a big part of this offense.
Anthony Wright's numbers tonight, 16 to 27, 186 yards. And Mike Staley already with 26 carries in this ballgame. As there's a timeout on the field, Gamecocks will take it with him. 8:19 left to play. The Spirit of Atlanta. And here's the Spirit of the South Carolina team, Deuce Staley.
What's up, bro?
Well, he has really done some kind of job. You name it, he's done everything tonight. This is pass. Stop short of the 15-yard line. Mike, how devastating is this to Georgia? Game's not over, but it's headed that way quickly now. They got surprised at home by Southern Mississippi, and now this one tonight.
Well, I think it's a tough, it will be a tough loss. The Southern Miss was a tough loss, but let's go back to that last series. They had Anthony Wright trapped in the back inside the 10-yard, and they didn't make plays. The players aren't making plays. It's not Jim Donnan, and it's not his staff. They're not making the plays they need to play, they need to make.
This is Edwards. They run back into the short side of the field, and he maybe has one, but Darren Hendricks says that's all. You'll get no more.
And Ron, it's not going to get any easier because they got Texas Tech coming up, but this is a good football team, and they've got talent.
Looks like he's had a cramp. Yeah, excuse me.
And they will start playing once they quit dropping the football, and once they make the sacks, and once they do all the things that they're not making tonight. And they didn't make those plays against Southern Miss, and you're going to get beat.
Well, a couple of the things that have happened to him tonight were also exceptional athletic ability of Deuce Staley and Anthony Wright making them miss.
Offside defense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Ron, one thing about Jim Donnan, he can take the heat. He's been in a lot of heated situations. He coached in Missouri, Oklahoma with Barry Switzer as the offensive coordinator and had those great teams. Marshall did a great job, and he will do a fine job here at Georgia.
Mike, one of the things has been turnovers. And the fact that we're going to show you a graphic in just a second, that there it is right there. 8 turnovers so far this season in 2 games, only 21 all of last season. Hines Ward caught it, but he went on one knee at the 24. That's enough for the first down, so that'll take the crowd out of it for a moment. But we only have 5-10 to play in the ball game. Here's another number that's interesting. Edwards, 135 yards rushing in the first half. He only has 22 in the second half. Part of that's the injury.
Yeah, I think it's the injury. He's not been able to run like he wanted to run here in the second half, like he did in the first half. And the other thing I think is important, when you watch Georgia, you can see them pressing. They're pressing. They got a new staff. They're pressing. The players are pressing, trying to do the best they can. And sometimes the results are mistakes.
Is underthrown. Sylvester Miller, you could see number 55 coming after him, is Juan Daniel, the intended receiver. But Miller caused him to go ahead and throw it early.
And I want to go back to last year when I saw this South Carolina defense against Florida. I mean, they were annihilated, ran on, passed on, everything. And Wally Burnham got a lot of heck last year from a lot of people saying, hey, you know, what's wrong with your defense? Well, I'll tell you right now, they couldn't have played much better than they have in the second half here. A good design behind it. And number 18, Darren Hambrick, brings a lot to this ball club. A lot of winning spirit from Steve Spurrier's program.
Well, the fans are on their feet. You could see the defense bouncing around. Bobo incomplete. Threw it behind the intended receiver, and it's going to be a third down as Terry Cousin had the cover on the play. Next Saturday, ESPN is the place to be. At 12:30, Pittsburgh looks to change its fortunes against Ohio State. Then at 7:30, this is where we will be. The LSU Tigers battle Auburn in Auburn, Alabama. But first, start the day with College Game Day at 11:30 and scores and highlights of the Residence Inn College Football Scoreboard at 3:30, 7, and 10:30. Here's the play that could be good night for the Dogs.
Good night, Irene, if they don't make this. Maybe they have a fourth one to try it.
Bobo's got it complete. That's good for the first down across the 35-yard line. And it's Ben Washington making the defensive stop on number 12, Juan Daniel.
And what you want to do now, if you're South Carolina, you want to punish the receivers. You want to give up the short passes, but punish them. Nothing long against you. Mike Bobo setting up, drilling this football. Juan Daniels with another big catch. Ben Washington, Terry Cousin on the tackle.
Hit just as he was getting the pass away. And again, South Carolina relentless on defense. I think Maynard Caldwell is the man that bumped into him just as the pass was being gotten away. Yep, there's Maynard right there, and he seems to be a little bit shaken up.
They were not sure whether Maynard Caldwell would start the game tonight because, or even play, because he had an injured ankle and didn't practice this week.
Some of the 82,950 on hand here tonight as they're trying to stretch Edwards on the sideline. Obviously, it was more than cramps. John Abraham, the freshman, put the pressure on him. Mike Tirico, no pressure on you. What you got for us,
Carter? Well, Ron, we have our third consecutive week with an overtime game in 1A. Pitt won the toss, chose to play defense. Houston scored a touchdown. Pitt couldn't pick up a first down, so Houston beats the Panthers in overtime, 42-35.
Hey, Mike, that means that Houston now, what, they scored 34 last week against LSU and 42 this week. They're putting the numbers up there.
Big play for Jim Donnan. You go to Hines Ward or Juan Daniels.
Ninth play of the drive. Bobo's pass is caught at the 40-yard line by Juan Daniels.
tell you, Ron, this Georgia team showing some resolve. Don't count them out yet.
24 yards in the play, 4:12 left in the ballgame.
They have all three of their timeouts left. And with the college rule, stopping that clock when you get a first down, there's worlds of time left in this ballgame. They just need to get in the end zone.
That is complete at the 30-yard line. 32 is Sel McCalloway, and it was Darren Hambrick who made the hit on him. So the hurry-up right now is working well for Jim Donovan and his Georgia football team, as they're down at the South Carolina 30. Down by 9 points.
Here comes a blitz.
Just overthrown, and that would have been a very tough catch, as Ray Green had the cover on Juan Daniels, and Anita had to caught it right back over the top of his head.
Yeah, see, you have to make those plays, though, right there. They telegraphed their blitz, so you knew you were going to have one-on-one on the outside with your best receiver, Juan Daniels, and he really didn't have to throw that as quick as he did because he had good protection on that play. Those are the plays you've got to make as a quarterback.
Third down. They need just over a yard. Stop the clock with 3:35 to play. Callaway takes it. I'll tell you, from where the side judge is coming in, Mike, he didn't pick up the first down. Of course, they go for it anyway in this situation. But it's not like they can have one here that they can toss and toss away. And Georgia wants to talk it over as they call timeout with 3:12 left. And we'll take the break with them. When we come back, it'll be fourth down and a couple of feet. Well, not many folks have left this one. 3:12 left, South Carolina 23-14.
Ron, here's what they had last time. Just a quarterback sneak on that defense would have picked up the first down, but they took the ball off the line of scrimmage. We'll see if they give them the same look.
So it's first down for Georgia as Robert Edwards gets the carry.
Henry Taylor.
Now you got to start thinking no huddle and line of scrimmage with your linemen, calling two plays, and getting this ball in the end zone as quickly as you can. Had to burn a timeout, but they still have two left.
Now the clock is back in, about to go under 3 minutes. Bobo will be sacked. Taylor got him from the top side, and down below, John Abraham. How proud do you think they are of these big freshman defensive ends, Mike? Well, they have really contributed tonight.
Yeah, you've talked about it all night, the two freshmen, and Abraham making a big play. And I'd say, again, Henry Taylor is absorbing some blocks, number 90 there. He's in the face of Mike Bobo and never get the ball off.
Bobo's pass caught right over the middle, Juan Daniels.
And that's what you want to do in long yardage situations, second and 21. Just pick up a half of it. Give him a chance to run the football after it. Put yourself in third and 10. South Carolina's making this Georgia offense work.
Daniels now with 5 catches for 81. Bobo incomplete as it was hit by Arturo Freeman. I'm not even sure if he saw the ball or not.
Remember, Mike Bobo's father's a high school coach, so he's been through all this play calling with his father. So he goes over to Jim Donovan and he says, I may have seen something. I think that's what he was trying to tell him. I see something in there. Let me try this. I don't know whether Jim Donovan's going to give him some freedom here or not.
Well, let's see who they look for. Juan Daniels has 5 catches in the second half. South Carolina is calling a timeout on this fourth down play. They want to make sure they got everything in order. So the Gamecocks stop the clock with 2:04, and we'll hold it right here. And reminding you that coming up next, the Residence Inn College Football Scoreboard Show. The top stories, and of course the top 25 scores and highlights. Boulder bound as well. We'll take a trip up to Colorado and Super Saturday as Chris, Kirk, and Lee look at next week.
Well, I've got to give Lee Corso credit now. I saw he threw on the Michigan hat today and picked Michigan over Colorado. So
he did,
got it right.
He did pick
Vim. I worry about his safety out of Boulder tonight.
Lee is fast asleep right now. Remember last year I said he was fast asleep, and I called out the hotel in Bristol that he was staying, and he got 400 calls. We woke him up on something he had said.
Those creditors are bad guys. 2:04 left to play in our ball game. South Carolina 23, Georgia 14. And the situation is a fourth down play for Georgia as they have the ball at the Gamecocks 28-yard line. Robert Edwards pops on the headgear and the chin straps and is set to go on this fourth down play. What do you call, Mike?
Well, the 12th man here for South Carolina is up there. I look for Hines Ward. He's the receiver I'm going to try to get the ball to.
Pass, the throwback screen, complete, and boy, did they read it. Defensively, Bobo got a hit, but Karis Sullivan was right there. It is almost as though he was in the Georgia huddle.
Well, remember now, they threw that screen twice successfully, and South Carolina was waiting on that call. Karis Sullivan waiting on the screen, and he played it perfectly and turned the lights out in Georgia.
I'll tell you, the stadium, we thought they went crazy when the team came out for the theme of 2001, which they always do, but it is about to erupt. Nobody wearing South Carolina colors has left this ball park tonight. Deuce Taylor, two hands on the football, will go forward to the 35-yard line. Georgia does have two timeouts left. And they have just spent one of those, so now they only have one remaining. Well, tonight's Visa players of the game are from Georgia. No surprise for either club. Robert Edwards, 22 rushes, 159 yards, and a touchdown. And from South Carolina, Deuce Stadel. His numbers, 28 rushes, 161 yards, 68 yards receiving, and a touchdown. As a part of their continuing effort to further the development of amateur athletics, Visa is proud to donate $1,000 to each of these universities on behalf of these athletes. Taylor, outstanding game for him tonight as we hand out some kudos in this one. We talked so much about Hamburg, but Taylor, and also John Abraham, Matt Marsters, the two freshman defensive ends. They had a lot of people who stepped up big. Freeman had an outstanding game. Ben Washington as well.
And Ron, a lot of
Shane Burnham in the middle, too.
Right, and a lot of people may wonder why Georgia didn't take a field goal in that last situation, but the problems they had earlier in the game with the field goal team probably was the reason that they chose not to and tried to go for the first down.
Now you see him run the sweep, try to eat up a little more time, and Deuce is doing more than that. He's eating up yardage. In fact, he is very close to picking up the first down as Chant Bailey stops him.
Well, we talked about the matchup we had of two great running backs tonight, and of course Robert Edwards' second half was marred by an injury, and you can see the turn of events. 14 more touches of the football by Staley, 268 yards to 159, but the Edwards' injury hurt him in the second half. But Deuce Staley has shown you his durability in this football game. He's been a receiver, a return man, a blocker, a runner. He's done it all tonight.
Straight ahead with the ball is Mixon, and we are under 1 minute to play. Georgia can stop it only one more time as they pick up the first down. Coming up, the Residence Inn College Football Scoreboard. And for that man, Brad Scott, boy, what a gigantic evening for him, for his staff, and for this program at South Carolina.
I'll tell you how long he's going to enjoy it for, about a half hour, because he's got Marcus Crandall up next with East Carolina.
And they can't be in too good a mood after losing by one at Morgantown.
10-9. Steve Logan, a solid coach with a good ball club. And that'll be an interesting ball game, because emotionally, when you get up for this kind of ball game next week, you got to get up the same way.
Well, for people that have got South Carolina on their schedule this year, still the folks in the know and looking at this team. They have got so many freshmen and sophomores that probably for Brad Scott, next year is the year you really got to point to. But right now, this is getting him off to a tremendous start.
You know, I think Hembrick, the fact that he came out of that Florida program, he's brought a lot to this. He's brought an attitude to this team. And his coaches will all tell you, he's been the difference on that defense. He refuses to let them lose.
Mike Bobo on the sideline. And let's check in one more time with Kellen Winslow. Kellen.
Ron and Mike, Heisman Trophy winner George Rogers. Speaking of great running backs, tell me what you think about Deuce today.
He looked like a Heisman Trophy candidate, don't he?
He sure did.
What a great running back, man. I tell you what, that run he made, he broke about three or four tackles. That's the way you do it, man. Deuce, I'm so proud of him, man. Just the Gamecocks in general. You know, I'm from Georgia, and at any time we can get a win over them, man, hey, I can go back home and I can brag about it. That's it.
Well, guys, you can see George is rather happy about this win today. Back upstairs.
Okay, thanks, Kellen. Thanks to George for stopping by. Yeah, this is going to be a happy night in Columbia.
Well, they have a drive here. As you come in on the road today, as you were driving us in, I saw George Rogers drive. And if number 22 continues like he's going, they'll have to find a little street to put his name on here before long if he can continue these numbers he put up tonight.
Juice Street, huh?
Yeah.
Right, straight ahead. Hines Ward, the outstanding athlete for Georgia, can only look on with 49 seconds left. It is a first down, and that's it. They'll start singing. This man right here has got to get back to Athens and start preparation for a Spike Dykes football team that probably should be 2-0, but they are very good. And not only hands barred, but defensively, Texas Tech is good.
Ron, they are good. Spike Dykes is one of the best coaches in college football, has an outstanding staff, and you know they're going to be ready to play. You can't take too long to be down about this one. You got to get right back up. To the offensive team, this is the favorite play in the playbook.
Oh, listen to the crowd. Brad Scott, yeah, there's the smile, finally. Didn't want to do it too quickly, but this is a happy group of campers here, and why not? Before a record.